Welcome to Amy Kudashian and the Expert Show, where the experts share their knowledge, wisdom, and powerful insight to help you transform your business and personal life. I am your host, Amy Kudashian, not Kardashian. And this segment, we are going to talk about how to turn your pain into power. What a subject. Who doesn't have pain in our lives, really? But it's the key how to turn it around to power. My guest is Shane Randall. Welcome, Shane. How are you?
Thank you. I'm wonderful. Thank you for having me.
Nice to have you. This is a really deep subject, and
Yes. Everyone
has some type of pain in their life, even if they know how to be positive and how to really go, put their feet on the side or whatever it might be. We have pain. It's like we need food. Everybody wants to eat, and everybody has some type of pain comes through their life. It basically, everyone could relate to this subject.
Yes.
And I want to know your background a little bit and why you are teaching about this subject.
Great question, Amy. So for me, I'm sure a lot of our viewers can probably relate to maybe at some point in their life being young and impressionable, and maybe having their environment influence them in a way that maybe they believe something about themselves to be true when it actually wasn't. So in my case, I grew up in a small town in Colorado. I did have a mom and dad growing up. My father, the way he showed love is he was a workaholic, and he provided very well, God bless him. Mm-hmm. But even though, Amy, I lived in the same house as my father, I didn't really know him. And specifically, I never got any male identity from my father. And so, you know, going on to grade school and that type of thing, you know, at least boys, you know, normally we go through this kind of testing and affirming process, whether it be on the playground or whatever it is. And, you know, it's a whole process, kind of a rites of passage a little bit, where we get to internalize that we have what it takes to be a part of this world. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, that world becomes familiar to us, and the mystery, of course, becomes, you know, ladies normally, and we get to focus on that. But for me, Amy, I opted out of that journey because I didn't feel prepared for that. So I put my flag over here with what I knew, which was safe and what was familiar, and that was women, because I was primarily raised by my mother and my grandmother. They were the dominant influences in my life at that impressionable, you know, years of my life. So long story short, Amy, fast forward. You know, of course, the problem with that, you know, hanging out with girls, of course, I was called gay, I was called this and that. And over time, the problem with that was that women became overly familiar while simultaneously men became the mystery. So moving forward in life, you know, we tend to gravitate toward the mystery. And so in my 20s, I struggled with my sexual identity and I felt like I was the only one. You know, I felt ashamed. I basically lived a double life for a few years of my life. I accepted that I must be gay because they told me who I was, and they must have saw that in me before I could. So I accepted that about my life. And so basically, Amy, I'm sharing this story just so people can know that, number one, you get to choose who you want to become in this life, and you don't have to answer to labels or what people called you, and
just answers you what you believe in yourself.
That's right.
Who you are.
And then the second thing is to know that, you know, your pain can truly become your power, because, Amy, as you can imagine, that was one of the most painful experiences of my life, because I was by myself experiencing
giving different identity, basically.
Totally.
Yeah.
Detached from my gender, not knowing who I was in that area. And, you know, fast forward, you know, I basically had to, it's kind of like when you're going down the road, you know, down the freeway, you're going 70 miles an hour. If your tires are out of alignment, what happens? You know, the car shakes, it's bumpy. It's an indication that something's wrong. Something has to be fixed. So in my own life, Amy, I chose to, if we're using the analogy of a car, to lift up the hood of my life, go into the engine, which was my pain driving my life, and go to the underlying events to find out where this all came from and be able to change the meaning of that event, which of course would change the belief about myself. And so today, I know more of who I am as a man than I ever have. And what used to be, or at least I perceived to be, the biggest liability of my life actually became the biggest asset.
So let me ask you a question. When did you discover that you were living other people's vision of you or believe in you? When did you discover that? Where did you stop the car and opened it to see what it is?
Very good question. It was in my mid-20s. I had accepted this part of my life that I must be gay, lived that life for about 3-4 years, and I was out of alignment. That piece of the puzzle wasn't fitting my life, even though I just was like, I had this yearning, I did have this attraction for men, but what I realized, Amy, is it was really a drive to find my own masculinity,
yes,
that I didn't feel like I possessed in other men. So that's really what I wanted, was affirmation and brotherhood and identity from what
you would wanted have, to take that. So
yes.
I know earlier you said you were in your 20s when that happened, but
yes,
there is any incident, like any particular time that you had an aha moment or something to say, oh, now this something moved you?
Yes, it was just, I always felt like there was more to the story, because I would always talk to other men in my same, you know, that had the same experience. And it was quite interesting how a lot of them did not have really close father figures in their life, you know? And so I just had to dig a little bit deeper. But to answer your question, yes, I got to the place in my life where I ended up at this place and was like, how did I get here? Like, I know this is not me. I just turned into this person that I wasn't.
Yes.
And it was something that, even though I didn't know where to go from there, Amy, I knew this wasn't it.
It wasn't it.
And the pain of staying where I was greater than the pain of going into what was uncertain, into digging.
So what you're saying here, you're telling everyone to say, when you feel you're in the wrong place and you're in pain, that means that's a sign.
Absolutely.
That's a sign for you to dig deep and say, well, no, this is something not right here. So when you're going through the pain, the
yes,
pain is a sign.
The pain is a sign. And also, it doesn't matter what your pain is. The greater the pain, the greater the capacity you have for power in your life. And just to know that you're not beyond that, that you literally, we pay the price of pain, and we can consciously choose to either live in the prison of our pain or be able to have that pain propel us like a rocket into places that we're strong in, that we never imagined we could be this strong in. And ask yourself one question: am I using my pain, or is my pain using me?
That's a good one. So ask yourself the question, is I'm using my pain, or the pain uses me?
Yes.
That's pretty good. Would you please give us your information? Because a lot of people, like I said, they are in pain and they want to reach out to someone who passed it and who was able to get to the other side.
Yes.
And they need some help. So how they can connect with you? This is, you could look there and give them your...
Great. Yes, you can connect with me by going to my website, yourpainispower.com. And you can also find me on all social media. My handle is at Shane Randall, S-H-A-N-E-R-A-N-D-A-L-L, 111. And that's how they can find me.
Well, thank you so much for coming on the show and sharing your experiences. Some people, they have so many experiences, but they don't really want to come out and share, because
yes,
there is different kind of pain with that.
Right.
To be open and share. And I admire you for doing what you're doing, because
you
are giving hope to someone else probably right now,
yes,
listening, and they're going in the wrong direction, and you're
yes,
probably going to help them to find their way.
That's
so
my hope.
Thank you. I appreciate
thank
you so
you,
much.
Amy.
And for you, the listeners, I hope you walked away with something really powerful here. Sometimes one word could change your life. I have a next guest. You don't want to go anywhere. You're going to learn more things on this show, and we'll be right back.
Snap-on Dentures will change your life. And at Smiles Today Dental, we now offer the lowest price in town. Mini dental implants can stabilize your loose dentures permanently. Call Smiles Today Dental for a free consultation.
Thank you for calling Dental Revival.
Hate to say goodbye to your favorite jeans? Well, now you don't have to, because Denim Revival is here for you. Mail us your jeans and our professionals will fix it right up. We offer you all kinds of alteration services, including invisible repairs, let outs, taperings, and original hemming, or even have your own custom-made jeans. quoted the best denim repair shop by GQ, Vogue Magazine, and LA Times. Denim Revival, your search for alteration and repair ends here.